to another video from Redline Technologies. I'm Kushan.
And I'm Sabrin.
And today we'll be bringing a preview for you. Asus have been kind enough to send us over a brand spanking new Z97 Sabertooth motherboard.
So some of you might be surprised that the Z97 chipset from Intel has even come out. It hasn't even been a year since they released the Z87 motherboards, and we already have Z97 here. Z97 itself has been announced, has been launched, will be hitting retail shelves soon. It's available overseas right now in Sri Lanka. We at Redline Technologies, as always, are the first store in Sri Lanka to bring you Z97 motherboards. We have a couple of others in stock. We'll let you know about that some other time. Because right now we're looking at the brand new Asus Sabertooth Z97 Mark 1. Before we get into the actual specs of the motherboard, let me just run you through the differences between Z87 and Z97. Fortunately or unfortunately, you're not going to see a lot of differences. It's very incremental changes. All the good things about Z87 have been maintained. You've still got overclocking support for K processors. I'm going to run you through a couple of differences between both the Z87 and Z97 chipsets. To be completely honest with you, there is not a whole lot differentiating the two. Z97 is more of an evolution. Z87 really had almost all the features you could want on a chipset such as while the Z87 itself was an incremental evolution over the Z77. So we see more of the same on the Z97. You have all of the same features. It supports the same 1150 socket processors. You've got plenty of USB 3 native support. You've got SATA 3 native support. A couple of new things which I'd like to bring to your attention is that the Z97 chipset is the only chipset that's going to support the new 5th generation Intel Broadwell processor.
Due somewhere later this year?
Yes. Do not get that confused with Intel's Devil's Canyon Haswell refresh, which is coming up. Just so you know, that's a new batch of processors that Intel are going to be launching soon.
Actually, they are already here. So we'll be getting processors.
And
by the time you see this, we might already have the processors. It's essentially a the refresh of the Haswell architecture, the same architecture, fourth generation itself. And just updated version of the fourth generation itself.
Truth be told, it's only the only improvements in the new Devil's Canyon is really on the non-K processors. It's just a slight clock speed bump. You get about 100 or 200 megahertz bump across the board, depending on the processor model. Nothing really to get excited about. But what we really would be excited about is the Devil's Canyon Unlock K processors, which Intel have told us are going to be catered towards enthusiasts and are going to be by far better overclockers than the K processors that we saw previously. More on that later though, because today it's going to be about the motherboard, not about the processors, but we'll have another review on the processors soon as you get a hands on them. Right now what we're looking at is these are 97 chipsets. The only other feature that's worth mentioning about the new Z97 chipset is the support for both SATA Express and M2. These are both newer storage interfaces that allow for up to 10 Gbps speeds, and as you would know, SATA 3 or rather SATA 6 Gbps, which are one and the same, were able to only transfer up to 6 Gbps, which in the real world translates to about 550 Mbps theoretical maximum read and write speeds. With 10 Gbps, we are going to be seeing speeds closer towards 1 Gbps, which is 1000 MB/s, which is pretty amazing. Obviously, right now we don't have any SSDs or any other devices right now capable of making use of this particular port, but you can be sure, because it's natively supporting the new Z97 chipset, that we're going to see new devices capable of read speeds of higher than 800 and 900 Mbps.
I'm just copying Titan call in a minute.
In a minute. So, very exciting, because obviously, slower or rather faster copy times are always something that you know are welcome. So we'll keep you updated on that as and when the technology becomes available. But for now, the only things you really are going to have to keep in mind is the support for the new Broadwell processors, which is Intel's 5th generation, and the new M2 and SATA Express standards. Everything else about the two chipsets are pretty much identical, nothing really to write home about. So that's essentially everything, I guess.
So let's take a closer look at the motherboard itself. The box first, you'll notice it says Z97 Sabertooth Mark 1. The reason is there is also Mark 2, which is a much cheaper motherboard. This costs about $260, whereas that costs only $180. We'll have more information on that later. Just going around the box, it's standard Sabertooth packaging. They mentioned a few key features here, the standard thermal armor, the top 45, thermal radar, two, whatever that is, dust defenders, and one more key feature, it comes with dual LAN, which was not present on the Z87 Sabertooth. Let's take a closer look at the motherboard itself. You see the familiar thermal armor you find on Sabertooth motherboards. in the front, and also in the back you got the back plate, which is being called the tough 45. We got your back. Pretty standard set of features on the motherboard. 3 PCI Express slots, 4 RAM slots. Get the SATA ports over there. Everything else. And this comes with, as we told you earlier, it comes with dual LAN. So it comes with 2 LAN slots. Other thing is, this comes with 2 fans. Like, there is one fan that's supposed to fit in there, and one more that goes in there. And the thing about this is, you get these neat little fan controllers, which you can change the direction of which the fan spins. So if you want the airflow going in one direction or the other direction to get out dust mainly, so you can change the direction through that. And one of the newer features that we're talking about in the Z97 chipset, the SATA Express port is right there. This board also comes with, it's pretty much standard for a high-end. It has debug LEDs, but not the standard display that you expect to be somewhere. Rather, this has like the memory diagnosis over there, CPUs over there, the graphics card is over there. So if any of these components are faulty, that the respective LED will light up. So we don't have to run through everything to find out what's wrong with the motherboard.
Okay, so that wraps up our preview of the Asus Sabertooth Z97 Mark 1.
Yes, very incremental changes over the Z87.
Nonetheless, if you're getting it for free, I mean, yes, it's provided they sell it at the same price.
Yes.
You know, they're welcome. Like I said, faster copy speeds, read and write speeds, always something to look forward to.
Dual LAN is something
that's exactly
important.
That's another thing which I was very impressed with. And hopefully, the new Devil Scanning processes will provide
better overclocking.
Much better overclocking, because
yes.
I don't know if we'll probably do this in another review, but
yes,
our overclocks
so, yes.
of late on Haswell process haven't been the best.
They've been very bad.
Nothing wrong with the boards, though. The boards have been
boards
fantastic.
Have been fantastic, but
the processes have been very lacking.
Sir.
So
yes.
Hopefully the new Devil Scanning will deliver and we'll be able to hit 5 GHz plus on air.
Yes, that's a promise with Devil Scanning, actually.
Yeah, so something to look forward to. Stay tuned. We'd like to again thank Asus for sending us this motherboard as a review sample. Thank you so much.
Yes, before it's even available for sale anywhere.
For sale anywhere, we got the board. So that's essentially everything, really. We got a couple of other Z97 motherboards coming up as well, but more on that later. So we'll catch you on the flip side.